The Minute Repeater is the most complex complication in watchmaking. And we start now a saga of a few videos about the Minute Repeater with a test and with some explanation about that. We are now in Fleurier to speak with Mr. Michel Parmigiani, Master Watchmaker, about the history of this complication and its evolution through time. So, let's go.
A minute repeater is an object that gives you time on demand. This means that by activating a trigger, you will hear a different sound denoting the hours, the quarter hours, and the minutes. This function was invented to provide time during the night or discreetly in the pocket. But it was essentially for the night, because there was not such things as a switch at this time and you had to light a candle or an oil lamp to have a light. So when you wanted to know the time, you used a minute repeater. Before the minute repeater, watchmakers had invented the quarter repeater and the 5-minute repeater. Afterward came the minute repeater, which was invented by Thomas Mudge, the British master watchmaker who also had a great influence on chronometry as a whole. Thomas Mudge invented the minute repeater around 1750, which is quite early in the history of horology. Minute repeaters first came from clocks like this one. There are clocks that ring time automatically. By striking the hour en passant, they ring the quarters at 15, 13, 45 minutes, as well as the top of the hour, but they don't ring the minutes. Other clocks also worked on demand by activating a trigger, like the Neuchâtel clocks, for instance. By pulling a small cord, it would ring the hour and the quarters. The clock was usually secured to the bed to provide the time during the night, as a minute repeater in the pocket would later do. The minute repeater we know today is not a simple reduction of a clock movement. To master it, you also have to master the gear train, the pivots, and the distance between the center of the staff bearings, for instance.
Tout cela doit être bien géré pour pouvoir imaginer une réduction.
But to create a wristwatch from a pocket watch, this is another story.
C'est encore une autre affaire.
The minute repeater appeared in the wristwatch during the 1920s. The reduction of the mechanism was difficult and required a lot of experimentation before we could build the first wristwatch minute repeater.
Avant d'aboutir à réaliser une montre répétition minute bracelet.
Today we master this kind of watch because miniaturization is much easier than before.
Beaucoup plus aisé au jour d'aujourd'hui qu'à une époque.
Indeed, in former times, it was much more artisanal production, requiring a lot of craftsmanship. It was actually hard to master the extremely small minute dimensions of the components. Nowadays, the high level of technology makes it easier.
Par rapport au jour d'aujourd'hui, avec tous les moyens technologiques qu'on a à disposition.
De toute façon, in any case, the human hand will always intervene in the process of building a minute repeater because of the complexity of the numerous adjustments needed. So we will always need a watchmaker to complete a minute repeater.
Qui va terminer sa répétition minute pour aboutir à sur un objet tout à fait fiable.
The first minute repeaters for the pocket contain little bells instead of gongs, even if we call them gongs. They were made out of bronze. You could have one or two bells with two different tonalities. Bronze gongs have been abandoned for aesthetic reasons. Indeed, it was not possible to create watches elegant and thin enough for using them.
Des questions esthétiques parce que on n'arrivait pas à réaliser des montres assez fines, assez élégantes et assez minces.
The gong crafted more as a vibrating wire when it was invented. It also needs to be tuned. The gong as a spring following the circumference of the movement allowed us to make much thinner watches. They can loop once around the movement or even one and a half times around.
Donc ils font un tour ou plus qu'un tour, ça peut être un tour et demi ou plus.
The short ones are consequently simple gongs, and the longer ones cathedral gongs. As they are longer, the sound of the cathedral gongs resonates more.
Ce qui a pour effet de porter le son beaucoup plus